Welcome to another practice video. First, we confess we have a severe continuity problem, which necessitates this practice. That is why we're doing it. The severe continuity problem means we are terrified of having a abrupt change in our experiencing from one experience to another experience that has nothing in common with the previous experience. It's we going from lies to truth, from illusions to reality. That is what we fear. So we are aware that we have this severe continuity problem, and we know that the vision of oneness, the vision of non-relative beauty, the vision of non-relative loveliness, it's all the same vision. Different way, different terms to describe it. We know that that resolves the continuity problem for us because it reminds us of reality. So we have an intermediate step here. The vision of oneness is an intermediate step. We're practicing for a soft landing into the vision of beauty. Okay, vision of beauty is what we're practicing here. The bright, divine, unlimited light of beauty rests upon everything as it is that I see. The clean, transcendent, unconstricted light of beauty is everywhere that I see. The fresh, grand, unconditional light of beauty touches everything that I see. The exquisite, holy, sheer light of beauty gently rests upon everything that I see. The ineffable, sacred, complete light of beauty softly abides with everything that I see. The majestic, lofty, full dress light of beauty touches everything that I see. The ethereal, splendiferous, organic light of beauty effortlessly abides with everything that I see. The perfect, the pure, the unreducible light of beauty gently abides with everything that I see. The splendid, the natural, the unitary light of beauty softly touches everything that I see. The superb, the complete, the unbroken light of beauty overlays everything that I see. The flawless, the lucid, the faultless light of beauty smoothly touches everything that I see. The incomparable, the unalloyed, the blameless light of beauty touches everything that I see. The superlative, unclouded, spotless light of beauty rests upon everything as it is. The precious, immaculate, stainless light of beauty rests upon everything as it is. The matchless, the supreme, the unblemished light of beauty is effortlessly resting upon everything as it is. The wonderful, the beautiful, the crowning light of beauty effortlessly touches everything as it is. The sublime, the lovely, the marvelous light of beauty is resting upon everything as it is. the exalted, the godly, the august light of beauty is touching everything as it is. The mystical, the regal, the glorious light of beauty is effortlessly resting upon everything as it is. Okay, very great. So, we just cool down a little bit, we just sit here. This is conditioning, counter-conditioning to the conditioning of the ego of the world, of those who have come here into this world, as everyone does, unaware of the continuity problem, in denial of the continuity problem, in denial of it, in denial. It is this denial that we have a continuity problem which causes us such severe suffering. When we accept that we have a continuity problem, right away then we begin to say, oh, what needs to be done about it? And these practices come, the Holy Spirit gives us these practices, says, just practice this and you will see. You will begin to align your valuing with the vision of oneness, with the vision of the light of beauty, with the vision of the light of loveliness, equally, effortlessly, blissfully, peacefully resting upon everything as it is. We align with that. So of course, if we're in denial that we have a continuity problem, we're not going to do these practices. It's crazy, right? We'd say, what for? I don't have a problem. I don't need this light of beauty to be non-relative, light of beauty be resting upon everything. What's that for? It's nice, I guess it's nice, but not really relevant. I mean, we need to make progress, we need to, you know, how is that relevant? It's just kind of a, you know, zoning out and spacing out. What is that? So, of course, the key is to recognize we have a continuity problem. That is the absolute key. Otherwise, we won't be taking the remedy. It's like we have a headache. We need the remedy. We have a continuity problem. We need the remedy. These types of practices suggested by the Holy Spirit are very, very, very helpful. We can double up now. We'll try one more here. Let's push things here. We're going to do the great doubling up exercise that the Holy Spirit suggested. The brightness of the light of beauty. May the brightness of the light of beauty rest upon you. May the cleanliness of the light of beauty rest upon you. May the freshness of the light of beauty rest upon you, rest upon everything. May the exquisiteness of the light of beauty rest upon all. May the ineffableness of the light of beauty rest upon all. May the majesticness of the light of beauty rest upon all. May the etherealness of the light of beauty gently rest upon all. May the perfect perfection of the light of beauty rest upon everything as it is. May the splendidness of the light of beauty rest upon everything as it is. May the flawlessness of the light of beauty rest upon everything as it is. May the superbness of the light of beauty rest upon everything as it is. May the incomparableness of the light of beauty rest upon everything as it is. May the superlativeness of the light of beauty rest upon everything as it is. May the precious preciousness of the light of beauty rest upon everything as it is. May the matchless matchlessness of the light of beauty rest upon all as it is. May the wonderful wonderfulness of the light of beauty rest upon everything as it is. May the sublime sublimity of the light of beauty abide with all as it is. May the exalted exaltedness of the light of beauty gently rest upon everything as it is. May the delicate delicateness of the light of beauty gently abide with everything as it is. May the mystical mysticality of the light of beauty gently abide with everything as it is. May the divine divinity of the light of beauty rest upon everything as it is. May the transcendent transcendedness of the light of beauty gently abide with everything as it is. May the grand grandness of the light of beauty rest with everything as it is. May the holy holiness of the light of beauty touch everything as it is. May the sacred sacredness of the light of non-relative beauty abide with all as it is. May the splendid splendiferousness of this light of beauty abide with everything as it is. May the pure purity of this light of beauty abide with everything as it is. May the natural naturalness of the light of beauty be with everything as it is. May the complete completeness of this light of beauty rest upon all as it is. May the lucid lucidity of this light of beauty abide with everything as it is. May the unalloyedness of the light of beauty touch everything as it is. May the unclouded uncloudedness rest upon of the light of beauty rest upon everything as it is. May the immaculate immaculateness of the light of beauty rest upon all as it is. May the supremely supreme, may the supreme supremeliness of the light of beauty abide with everything as it is. May the beautiful beauty of the light of beauty abide with us all as it is. May the lovely loveliness of the light of beauty rest upon us all as it is. May the godly godliness of the light of beauty abide with us all as it is. May the regal regalness of the light of beauty rest upon everything as it is. May the glorious glory of the light of beauty abide with everything as it is. May the unlimited unlimitedness of the light of beauty rest upon all as it is. May the unconstricted unconstrictedness of the light of beauty rest upon all as it is. May the unconditional unconditionalness of the light of beauty rest upon everything as it is. May the sheerness of the light of beauty touch everything as it is. May the full dress of the full dressness of the light of beauty abide with everything as it is. May the organic organicness of the light of beauty touch everything as it is. May the unreduced unreducibleness of the light of beauty abide with everything as it is. May the unitariness unitary unity of the light of beauty abide with everything as it is. May the unbroken unbrokenness of the light of beauty abide with everything as it is. May the faultless faultlessness of the light of beauty abide with everything as it is. May the blameless blamelessness of the light of beauty abide with everything as it is. May the spotless spotlessness of the light of beauty rest upon us all as it is. May the stainless stainlessness of the light of beauty rest upon everything as it is. May the unblemished unblemishedness of the light of beauty rest upon us everything as it is. May the crowning crown of the light of beauty rest upon everything as it is. May the marvelous marvel of the light of beauty touch everything as it is. And may the august augustness of the light of beauty touch everything as it is. So, feeble practices, just feeble little practices here. But we put our 10 cents in, God puts his $10,000 in. We put our $1 worth of effort in, the Holy Spirit puts its $1 million worth of effort in on our behalf. So we're just doing a little bit of feeble practice, and I know the world will laugh at us and say, what is that? That's ridiculous. What are you wasting your time for? Such little feeble efforts. What are you praying to? What are you hoping for? It's nonsense. Because they're in denial of the continuity problem. But we are not in denial of the continuity problem. It is the key essential recognition that we have this continuity problem, and we take the Holy Spirit's advice on how to resolve it, which is to do these practices for a soft landing into the vision of beauty, the vision of loveliness, the vision of oneness. If we don't do this, the problem is still there, but it's denied. And then the ego takes over and says, hey, nah, you don't have that continuity problem. You got some other problem. And then you say, yeah, I know I got some problem. Oh, okay, ego, it's this other problem. Okay, what do I do about that other problem? Then the ego says, well, you need to learn how to blend truth and lies. You need to have the mutual exclusives are compatible. You need to learn how to make them compatible. You need to integrate. You need to synthesize. You need to unify. And you say, okay, ego, and you go on and on and on and on and on. In incredible difficulty and futility. Because the ego knows if we recognize we simply have a continuity problem, it's over for the ego as our advisor. It's over. It's finished. It's finished. How can the ego advise us how to solve the continuity problem truly with reality? It cannot. It cannot. Only the Holy Spirit can advise us correctly. So the ego has to bank everything on continued denial of the continuity problem. And we've pushed past that barrier here. And that's why we're able to do these exercises. And this is what we need to do. And it's a little feeble effort, but you know what? It really, really, really moves things incredibly towards the resolution of the continuity problem, and certainly moves us toward never having to be reborn here. Never having to be reborn in this kind of dualistic, relative, egoic place where we're trying to blend opposites, trying to unify opposites, trying to unify what isn't split, trying to make truth and lies, mutual exclusives compatible, trying to do the impossible. And of course, scapegoating, projecting, blaming, and on and on and on and on and on. Of the vision of the light of beauty, the light of non-relative beauty, the vision of the light of non-relative loveliness, the vision of oneness may not dawn upon us this moment. It may dawn upon us the next moment, or the next, or the next. But the fact is that in doing these practices, we are ending our long trek through the valley of futility, the valley of darkness. We don't have to return. We do not have to return, because we know it's merely a denial of the continuity problem and a delaying action toward before we admit that we have the problem. That's all that this world is a delaying action to keep us occupied with some other objective, with all these objectives and fake progress, thinking we're chasing after beauty. Okay, there's something beautiful. It's better than this over here, more beautiful than this. Let me chase after this. Oh, I'm progressing towards beauty. And keep us going that way. So we do not confess that we have a severe continuity problem. That's all that this world does. That's it. Once you admit you have a severe continuity problem, you accept it, you've repented, it's called. You've repented. You don't need the world anymore. You need it as a continuity help. You know, we're not throwing it away, but you don't need to return. You don't need to return here. You're a non-returner. As you do these practices, you become a non-returner to this horrible realm, this ghastly, insane asylum. You become a non-returner here. So, this is an investment in your spiritual future. This is an investment in your spiritual future. I was walking today towards a business, and suddenly the Holy Spirit seemed to suggest, saying, your job. I always wonder, what is my job? I don't know what I'm doing. How do I, says, you're a spiritual investment advisor in the future, a future planner. Like you have these people that, you know, plan the future of others. Let's sit down and plan your future out. Well, I guess my job is to, let's sit down and plan our spiritual future out. A spiritual future planner. What is our spiritual future? How to plan our spiritual future? And step one is don't come back here. I've always said the most important thing we can possibly do is don't come into this world in the first place. That is by far and away the best thing you could ever do. Don't come into this world in the first place, because it's an insane asylum, and it's an insidious insane asylum, and it will drive anyone mad, almost anyone mad here, drive everyone into misery, confusion. Don't come here in the first place. Don't come into this type of world in the first place. So how do we manage that? How do we plan for that? Invest in these exercises that deal with the continuity problem. That's how you do it. This is my future planning advice, my spiritual future planning advice. Just these little exercises, feeble as they are, you're listening, you're hearing, feeble as they are, and you can do them yourself. All I'm doing is writing down some descriptive terms and then using them in a simple practice. I'm just going along and doing it as I go along, and it just suggested to me, why don't I try this? And I try it. I say, oh, yeah, that works good. That's great. So if we know we have a continuity problem, we know how to practice on this continuity problem, we don't need to come here. There's no reason to come here. None. We can practice this anywhere. We don't have to be in this world to practice, do these practices. We can be in some other realm and say, may the immaculate, flawless, complete, natural, you know, precious light of non-relative beauty rest upon everything as it is. We don't have to be in this world to do these practices. So once you do these practices and you realize you can do it, you don't have to return. You don't have to return. That's how I see it. That's how I feel about it. That's why I'm doing them. I don't want to return here. That's for sure. That is 100% for sure. This world has never given me anything that I really want. Absolutely never, never, ever give me anything that I really want. And it never will. It never will. So, why come here? Because you're going to pursue what you really want, but with the denial of the continuity problem, you're going to go pursue it in a crazy way by trying to blend mutual exclusives. And that is going to cause you the most incredible, frustrating, confused, projected mishmash of a future. Just terrible. Bizarre, 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 bizarre. It always is bizarre. This world is always bizarre, actually. It really is. If you're honest about it, it is bizarre. And it happens kind of slowly most of the time, so we kind of keep trying to adjust, trying to adjust, trying to adjust, trying to adjust. And the kids that come here, you know, born recently, it seems to be kind of new to them, so they just pick up whatever's happening now, and they think, this is it, okay, I get it, I got it. And as they get older, they say, wait a minute, it's all changing in a bizarre way. What's going on? What's going on? You're young, you think the music you're listening to, that's the music you're supposed to be listening to, and that's it. It's good. For the rest of my life, this is the music. I love it. This is my music. It's never going to change. And then suddenly some different style comes in. You're like, what the heck is that? That's totally bizarre. What is that? What is that? I mean, it's happened to me over and over and over again, all these different musical styles. You know, it says, what in the world is that? I don't like that. I thought I had it. I thought this was the music that I love. This is what I really want. And it's going to stay that way. I said, huh? No. And society changes. Everything is in constant change here. And it always is going to turn in some bizarre way that you don't expect. But when you accept, you know what? My only problem is that I have a continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. It's the only problem I have. Then these exercises make sense. They're very reasonable. You say, ah, I can see this is working, aligning my expectations with the vision of oneness. So my expectations are aligned. It's not going to be a freak out, you know. It's going to be a soft landing into this light of beauty, the light of loveliness, non-relative loveliness, equally smoothed out, non-crystallized, seamlessly abiding and overlaying and resting upon and touching everything equally, everything equally, everything equally. Yes, this is what I really want. This is what I really want. Denial of the continuity problem isn't what I really want. That's what the ego tells you want. Just deny it, deny, 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 deny. It'll go away, the ego says. Just keep denying. Meanwhile, it's working hard to on its real plan, which is to get us to commit spiritual suicide, actually. That's what the ego really wants, to make itself safe from us, its maker, because it's a projection. It's not a split. We didn't split our will into two wills. It's simply is a projection. It is a disassociation on our part. So, wonderful practice here, and I will continue to see what I can do. And for me, the motivation, I don't want to come here again, for sure, for sure. And so I'm certainly very motivated. That is certain. Okay, very great. That's it for this practice video.